Good morning, students. So now we will discuss what are the characteristic properties of an image formed by a plane mirror. So we have seen that in the case of an image formation by a plane mirror, so image is formed behind the mirror, inside the mirror. So we can say that the nature of the image is virtually. So the first property is image formed is image formed. Is considered as a virtual image. So virtual image means this types of image cannot be obtained on a screen. We can see that in the case of a image formation by a plane mirror, image is forming inside the mirror. So we cannot obtain on a screen. So these types of images are known as a virtual image. Why the image formed is a virtual? Because we can observe that in the case of a reflected light rays, they are not meeting actually. So that is the reason we are getting this type of image, that means a virtual image. So the first property is image formed is considered as a virtual image, we can say. Then second property is you can observe that this image is erect also. It is the same straight as the object. So the other property is we can say that image formed is erect. Image formed is considered as an erect image. So this is another property we can say that image is formed is considered as an erect image. That means it should be straight as in the case of an object. So this is the second property we can say. Now we can answer the third property as you can observe that suppose if you are standing in front of the plane mirror. When you are looking into the image, you can see that the image formed is the same size as the object. So this is the third property we can say that the image formed is the same size as the object. Image formed is same size as the object. So this is considered as the third property of image formation we can say. The image formed is the same size as the object. Now, this another property we can see that suppose if you are standing in front of the plane mirror and you can raise your right hand, so you can see that image will raise the left hand. That means the right is appears as the left in the case of a plane mirror. Similarly, if you raise your left hand, you can see that image will raise the right hand. So this property of image is known as a lateral inversion. So the image formed is considered as a laterally inverted. So in this case, image formed in the case of a plane mirror is image formed is laterally inverted. So this is the fourth property we can say that. So image formed is laterally inverted. So lateral inversion means right of the object is appears as a left of the image, and the left of the object is appears as a right of the image. So this property is known as a lateral inversion. So image formed in the case of a plane mirror is considered as a laterally inverted. Then there is one more property is there. Suppose if you are standing in front of the plane mirror and you are going towards the mirror, so you can see that image is also approaching towards this mirror. So we can say that the image is formed behind the mirror as the object is in front of it. For example, we can say that this object is 1 meter in front of this mirror. Object is standing at 1 meter in front of this plane mirror. So we can observe that the image is also forming 1 meter behind the mirror. So we can say that the fifth property is the image is formed same distance behind the mirror as the object is in front of it. So image formed is same distance behind the mirror as the object is in front of it. So this is where we can consider the case of fifth property we can set. So these are the some of the important properties in the case of an image formation by a plane mirror. So the first property is image formed is virtual, and the second property is image formed is erect, and image formed is the same size as the object, and image formed is laterally inverted, and the fifth property we are seeing. So image formed is the same distance behind the mirror as the object is in front of it. Okay, thank you.